Welcome. This video is about new and old outlook. Many people don't like the new outlook and there is a lot of confusion about what is going to happen to old outlook. Is it going to be taken away and so on. So this video gives you the exact guidance of what to do. If you don't have time, I'll tell you the conclusion right now. Use both as of now. This is May 2023. If things change, I will come up with an updated video. But as of now, on the desktop, use the old Outlook so you get everything which you are used to. But there are some very nice features on the new version. And how do you get them? Open browser, ideally Edge, and use Outlook Web Access. All the new features are there as well. So best of both worlds, job done. I'm not going to go into a detailed comparison of both because it's unfair. There are hundreds and thousands of old features and they are not necessarily going to appear in the final new version. It's not just being migrated, it's being rewritten and only high priority popular things are going to go there. For some time, at least 1 year plus to my knowledge, both versions are going to be available. At some point, Microsoft may change the default from old to new, but still the option to switch back is going to be available for foreseeable future. So don't worry, just use this workaround. While we are at it, I will show you some new features which are really good. The first thing is PIN. It's simple. Every mail has a PIN button. Click on it. It sticks to the top. Even when new mails come, that will not be disturbed. Don't overdo it and remember to unpin it when your job is done. That's all there is to it. Otherwise, you will pin too many and that defeats the purpose. The other option which is very useful is storage account. By default, it will be your OneDrive business account. But when you drag drop a file from local drive, it gives you a clear indication. Do you want to send it as an attachment or a link? Recommended method is to send a link. And before you can create a link, of course, you have to upload it to OneDrive. After you put the link, if you want to change your mind, you can still do it or you can change the permissions. Easy and effective. The other thing is about color categories. We have been using them for quite some time in Outlook. But if you want to look at a particular category, either you have to filter on it through search or go and group them. Here it is a little simpler. If you go to a particular category very often, click on favorites and then you can add a category there. That's like a search folder in the older parlance. So when you click on it, in one click, you will see all the mails which have that category applied. Then we have a snooze option, which is also great, where you want to look at a mail, respond to it in detail, but right now you don't have time. And if you just leave it there, it'll go into unread and you may miss it later. So you click on snooze, choose the time at which that mail you intend to handle. And then it disappears from your inbox. It's not deleted, it's kept in a separate snooze folder. And then at the desired time, it'll appear in inbox. So there's a higher chance that you can handle it better. The other feature, which is also a part of old one, but little difficult to understand, is delayed send, not the old one. Old one delayed send is not very useful because if you say delayed send and then your Outlook is not open on the desktop, it doesn't work. This one, there's a drop down to send and say scheduled send. And there you can decide exactly at what time you want to send it. And the classic scenario is, I am the boss, I got some idea, I want to send it to someone, but Saturday afternoon. I want to send it now because I'll forget on Monday, but I don't want to disturb my team, so I can schedule it to be sent on Monday morning. So my head is clear and nobody is disturbed. Work-life balance for my team. In older Outlook also, you will get a mail tip, which gives you the same feature. Another useful feature is My Day. It opens as a separate pane on the right side. It shows you calendar and to-do. You can drag and drop any mail to convert it either to a meeting or to a task. The original mail is still available. You can also create a task when you right click on a mail, go all the way down, advanced actions, create a task. To avoid flagging emails, convert them to tasks. The best practice as of now is use both, older on desktop, newer on browser. Another option is use Windows app, which is the new version, and on the desktop app, use the old version. If you find this useful, do subscribe to my channel. I try to create one video every day. Click the bell icon so that you can get this content as soon as it is published. And more importantly, if I miss something, let me know. If you have some queries, I will be happy to answer them. And if you have ideas for more videos, that is the best input you can give me. Share it with as many people as you can so that everyone becomes more efficient. That's the idea behind this channel. And before you go, these two videos are related to Outlook and Tasks and Planner, new Planner. Have a look at those as well. So that's it from me. See you next time. Thank you for watching.